Here's Ginobili for three.
All right, so you know, as time goes on, we must say goodbye to a lot of great players.
So sad to see Ginobili go.
So sad.
Here's Ginobili for three.
Clutch.
Double overtime, too.
See, and the gist for that shot alone is why he should stay. Because he can make that shot now. You leave him open, it's over.
He's going to hit it.
Off the down screen, kick out. Why'd you leave him? See the misdirection? They sent Boris Diaw in the paint.
Cash.
Close out, hold that. He left it up there, too.
Yep, yep.
Like
keep
Bird.
It up.
Like Bird when he hit the game winner.
Word, yep. Hold that. You can see his passion, like, when he's hitting the shot or the celebrations after, like.
Yeah.
The Eurostep, though. Mm. Did he pioneer the Eurostep?
I play street ball a lot. I've seen a lot of people do the
Eurostep. Yeah,
before
yeah.
Before I even
it was called the Eurostep,
yeah,
right?
They would do it because, you know, a lot of fouls in the hood where I grew up.
Word.
And you getting ready to drive to the basket, and you see somebody down there, you just move away from them, and then you try to shoot it. But he turned it into an actual move where people are using it both ways now. It's effective, for sure, especially with you got a player like Ginobili coming down or, you know, even a guy like Westbrook coming down full speed, Eurostep.
No, Westbrook.
Yeah.
So what about Harden? Did he put Harden on? Or did Harden kind of just create his own style to it?
Well, you know, the thing is, Ginobili comes off a pick, gets you on his right hip.
It's a wrap.
You're going to have to foul him, or he's going to get an and one, or he's going to Euro by you. James does the same thing. The difference is, I think, he'll wait a couple times. He'll dance with you a little bit.
He will do that.
And get in his zone. We started off this conversation just speaking on Ginobili being a passionate guy. The players that play with passion stand out.
Right.
Who would you say is, you know, the best at that in the league right now?
I know we have to consider Westbrook. Yeah. He's never going to take a night off. I think you have to consider Draymond. Draymond's really passionate.
Yes.
I think a lot of players, you know, showcase it in their own ways.
LeBron James.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
His passion is on such a high level that he's taken scrutiny and made it a part of his fuel.
Yeah, that is true. I like that. Yeah. I like that.
Passion is something that, you know, people strive for. But is that a part of the component that it takes to be a winner, do you think? Even if you do lose, you still need to be that passionate to even put yourself in a position to win. Do you believe that?
Okay, yeah. In that case, yeah. I do think you should be passionate about whatever you do. Again, I think there are some people who showcase that passion in different ways. So, like, for example, you take somebody like Robert Horry. He was always there to fulfill the duties of his team.
Yes.
In that way, he's not going to be the most vocal guy, or, you know, be the most the guy who's going to be celebrating all the time.
And then you have the polar opposite, Dennis Rodman.
Exactly.
Yeah, I get it. You need that passion, but sometimes you need to learn how to use it in certain areas when you need it.
Exactly. What about you? I've seen you cook a lot of people, man.
I'm a complete savage. I don't have an ounce of anything other than passion in me.
That's real.
So as soon as I get on the court, I'm already angry.
Yeah.
I'm taking out all my frustration on whoever's in front of me.
I mess with that, though.
There we go.
For sure, bro. Hey. It's always good, man.
Hey, always good to see you, man. God bless you, brother.
Same, bro. Same.